exhale, it might feel good to even connect an audible sigh. So breath in. Feeling your jawline relax, your teeth unclench, your lips softening. Feel the muscles of the face relaxing. The fingers, the toes. And picture a string, an imaginary string at the top of your head. And as that string is gently being pulled, feel your spine lifting just a little bit more, keeping those shoulders soft. Maybe even noticing how your heart presses forward. And just begin to take this moment of observation, just noticing what you're feeling right now, noticing your breath. Using your exhales to help you release anything that's not serving you in this moment or for this practice. So if you're feeling physical tension in the body, if you're feeling a little tension in the mind, use your exhales to help release that tension. So as you take these next few moments to find your breath, to continue settling in, to just be in the state of observation, I'll give a little introduction of who I am for those who may be new to the Rachel Voss Yoga experience. So I am Rachel, and I have been teaching yoga since 2013. Yoga has been in my life since childhood by way of my stepmother, but it was a practice that was just kind of here and there, and I kind of do it and I wouldn't do it. And then I was at a point in my life in 2012 where it was just my emotional rock bottom. I have been through a tough marriage and divorce. I've been through single motherhood. I quit my job to teach yoga full time after just a lot of unfulfillment inside and just really searching for my purpose. So all of these things in my life that I had been through had kind of come at one point, and I was at my most emotional rock bottom point in 2012 when a friend said, you know what? I'm gonna get you some yoga classes. I was also in a really bad car accident at the time. So I was home from work, just physically, kind of broken up, emotionally broken up. And I took those yoga classes just as a way to do something to kind of just get out of the funk, if you would. And it was the third of those three classes where I looked at the yoga teacher, who looked nothing like me, but it was something about her peace, her ease, her joy, her happiness that spoke to me. And I was like, I need that in my life. And I just decided to pursue teacher training, not with the goal of ever teaching yoga, but just with the goal of learning more about this practice that seemed to just have this one teacher in this very sort of ethereal place. And so I enrolled in a teacher training program, again, with no intention to teach. But as always, when the student is ready, the teacher will appear. And my teacher saw in me what I could not see in myself at the time. And she nurtured the teacher that is in me. And so when I completed my training in 2013, I was like, okay, I'm done here. She's like, oh no, I have a class I created just for you to teach. And I started teaching one class in September of 2013. And after that first class, I knew right away I had connected with my purpose. I'm a person who's driven by being of service to others. I think my mom is on here. If she could speak, she'd tell you that right now. Since a little girl, I've always wanted to help people. I've always wanted people to feel good, to feel happy. And that's what caused me to struggle a lot of my career. I had a great career, but just not feeling good on the inside. And when I found this path that just allowed me to bring joy to others, to help people find joy within themselves, I knew I was on the right path. And so taught that one class for 2 years. And in 2015 is when I made my personal leap, leaving the corporate world and jumping into yoga full time. And that's how and where Rachel Voss Yoga was born. And so I've been doing this for 5 years. It is absolutely my passion, my joy. I really love to help people connect with their own purpose, their own sense of self. Why yoga? Because yoga is truly a practice, a journey that invites you to come home to yourself and to come home to yourself in a most authentic way, babe, in a most authentic way. It reminds you of your power. It teaches you empowerment. It helps you find personal empowerment. I always say these 72 inches of a yoga mat represent freedom and choice. And so it's just a place to remind you of who you are, to come back to who you are, especially when you get into those places of just kind of getting away. So yoga is a practice that invites you to come home. So I hope that you feel that today. I hope you feel good today. If this is your first time with yoga, have no worries. This is not going to be a super intense practice. I'm going to move a little bit, get the blood flowing, have a good time, smile, have fun, and then we'll bring it all together with a lovely restorative posture at the end, and then we can all go on and have the rest of our day. So with that, let's go ahead, take three more breaths, and then we will start to move. Inhale, nice and deep. Exhale. Breath in. Exhale out. Taking one more full deep breath in. And exhale. Now, if you're sitting with your legs crossed, it might feel good to switch the cross of your legs here. So if you have that left leg in front, go ahead and bring your right and vice versa. And then let's go ahead, begin to open up with some gentle side stretching. We're going to inhale, reach up through the sides of the body. Exhale, bring hands together at the heart. We're going to open up the side body and then turn this into a stretch. Inhale, one more time, reach up, shoulders soft. Exhale, hands to the heart. Actually, let's do that one more time. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Pause here for a moment. If there is an intention you want to set for your practice today, an affirmation you want to connect with, take a moment to settle your mind on that intention. Maybe it's being present, maybe it's being open, maybe it's dedicating this practice to someone in your life who is in need of loving and healing energy. Or maybe it's simply just saying thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to be here. Thank you for the body that allows you to move. Settle your mind on that intention and then bring it together. Exhale, seal your intention at your heart. One more breath in. Exhale. Let's bring hands outside of the hips. You can rest on palms or fingertips, whatever feels good. We're gonna inhale, left arm up, and as you exhale, reach, reach, reach over to the right, finding a beautiful stretch here in the left side of the body. Now, we want to be mindful not to drop your right ear into your right shoulder. You want to be mindful not to hug the left ear with the left arm. To deepen the stretch on the left side, walk that right hand out just a little bit more, but not so much that that left hip or left side of the body is starting to pop up. Anchor that left side of the body down and just really, really, really reach through those fingertips, the left fingertips. If it feels good, you can bring the gaze towards the hand or just keep the gaze towards the floor. Taking one more deep breath in. Exhale out. And then we're going to move right to the other side. Inhale, right arm comes up. Exhale, left hand outside of the left hip. Reach over through the right fingertips. Keep that right hip down. Walk your left hand out as much as you need to. And this time, be mindful not to collapse that left ear into the left shoulder. Try not to hug the right ear with the right arm. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, reach just a little bit more. Opening up what we call the intercostal muscles, so the spaces between your rib cage. Good. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale, we're gonna fold forward over the legs. You can do this from the knees with the legs straight. That's how you're sitting. Chin to chest, head to ground. Whatever feels good. You can walk the hands straight out. Walk the hands to the right. You can walk the hands to the left, getting a little more side stretch. Just take what you need here. Soften your shoulders. Let's pause here for three more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Good. One more full deep breath in. Exhale out. Beautiful. On the inhale, let's walk those hands back into the body. Come to sitting up. Take a breath in and a breath out. Getting a little gentle stretch for the shoulders here. I'm going to work through what we call eagle arms, bringing the arms straight out. And what we're gonna do is cross that left arm on top of the right, bending the elbows. Now, be where you are in your body here. You can either connect your palms, you can connect the back of the hand, you can hook your thumbs. If this just doesn't feel accessible to you with any of these options, come out of crossing the arms and simply press your forearms and palms together. Lift the arms. Good. Wherever you are. But not too high, but enough that you're feeling the stretch in the upper back. Good. Gently bring the arms slightly to the right. Just feel the stretch in the upper back. Now, relax the face. Are you squinting the eyes? Are you gritting your teeth? What yoga teaches us is how to relax our response to what we're feeling. So we want to try not to respond to tension and tension. Take one more deep breath in here. Exhale. Inhale, bring the arms up. Woo, fly out of those eagle arms. And then let's bring the arms back in front. This time we're going to cross right over left, bringing the palms together, backs of the hands, thumbs, whatever feels really accessible to you. Remember, if you want to connect those forearms instead, take that. Lift the arms just a little bit, not so high that you're not feeling a stretch and your chin is tilted up, but enough that you're feeling that stretch in the upper back. Ever so slightly, bring those arms to the left. Breathe, relax the face, sit tall, soften your shoulders. Learning to be present with what you're feeling, what you're noticing. Take two more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Nice and easy. One more full deep breath in. Exhale. Inhale. Let's fly out of the eagle. And as you do so, go ahead and shake your wrist. Your arms, maybe circle your wrist around. We're going to do a little bit more here from seated, finally stretching out these legs. But after our seated work, we're going to come to hands and knees. So if it feels good, just take a moment, take out your wrist, stretch out your wrists. Otherwise, let's go ahead and begin to prepare for our next posture. So I'm staying with my cushioning here. If you need to come off your cushioning, honor that. If you need the cushioning, take that. Let's go ahead and straighten out the legs. If you are sitting with your legs crossed, it might feel good, or with the knees bent, it might feel good to shake out the legs a little bit here. You can gently pound the legs to get the blood flowing, maybe circle around your ankles a little bit. So again, just listening to your body. And then let's go ahead and bring the hands by the hips. Your shoulders are lined up with your wrists. Your fingertips pointing towards your feet, so towards the front of the mat. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, press those hands down into the mat, draw your toes into the body, and start to invite the stretch that you're feeling in the back of the legs. Now again, notice how you're responding in your face. So we get into hips, hamstrings, shoulders, lower back. Those are areas that can cause us to like squint and grit and do all of that. We want to find our breath. We want to find ease in response to the tension, to the challenge. Again, the more we practice this in yoga, the more you start to apply that in your life off the mat. Take another breath in, exhale, spread the toes, keep drawing them in. One more breath in. Exhale. Beautiful. And let's open up those feet to a small V. And we're going to do a little more stretching and start to open up the hips a little bit here. We're going to take the sole of the right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Turn your torso to face the left knee. Keep your left toes flexed in. When you keep the toes drawn in or flexed in, this helps to keep the posture of the body active and engaged. Inhale, we're going to sweep the arms up. Take a breath in. Exhale, fold forward towards your left toes. Good, and you can hold on to the toes, the shin, the thigh. Be where you are. So in other words, if you're reaching towards your toes, but you start to feel yanking or resistance around the thigh or the shin, rest your hands there. We're gonna be here for a few breaths so you can inch your way towards the toes, being where you are in your body. Now, if that right knee is popping up, here's what we're gonna do. Keep your heart towards the left knee. Keep your torso twisted towards the left knee. Take that right hand to the inside of your right thigh. Breath in, and as you exhale, gently press that thigh down to the mat as though your right hand were a paperweight. Keep yourself folded towards that left knee. And then you can keep the right hand there or come back and hold onto the left foot with both hands as you continue to press that right thigh down. Keep your shoulders soft, relax your face. If you're not smiling, I invite you to smile here. And maybe drag that left heel forward just a little bit more. Take one more breath in. Exhale up. Beautiful. On the inhale, let's come to sit up. Gonna move through a twist, stepping our left foot over the right. Right hand is gonna come behind us. Take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, turn in towards that right knee, either hugging the right knee with the left arm or taking left elbow outside of the knee and gently, gently, gently bringing your gaze over the right shoulder. This is your twist. Keep those left toes drawn in. If you feel like you're straining in the neck, bring the chin back slightly towards the chest. Pause here, two more breaths, inhale. Exhale, maybe twist a little bit more towards that right shoulder. One more breath in. Exhale out, beautiful. Take an inhale, exhale, come back to center. Let's uncross that right leg and do that all on the opposite side. So sole of the left foot coming to the inside of the right thigh. We're now gonna turn our torso to face the right knee, draw those right toes in. Inhale as you sweep the arms up, soft shoulders. Exhale, fold forward towards the toes. Again, land wherever you are in your body. You may be tighter on the right side of the body than the left. So just notice what you're feeling, be where you are. Get that grip on your right leg, foot, whatever you're holding on to. And then if you need to press down that left thigh, same thing. Left hand comes to the inside of the left thigh. Press that thigh down as you keep yourself folding now towards or over that right knee. Relax the face. Breathe, breathe, breathe. And the way that you stay connected to your practice, or as I like to say, the way that you stay in the room, is by noticing what you're feeling in every single posture. Do you feel released? Do you feel resistance? Do you feel tightening? Let's take one more deep breath in. Exhale. Inhale, come to sit up. Let's find that twist on the opposite side. We're gonna step the left foot over the right, draw that right foot, right toes in. Left arm comes behind, inhale, and as we exhale, turn it in towards that left knee, hugging the left knee with the right arm or right elbow outside of the left knee, opening up that palm. Keep those right toes drawn in, gaze coming over that left shoulder. Twisting postures are a really nice way to open up space in the lower back. Two more breaths here, inhale, exhale. One more full deep breath in. Exhale. Beautiful, take a breath in, and as we exhale, come back to center. Let's uncross the legs, and we're gonna get ready to come onto hands and knees. So go ahead and grab your cushion if you need support for the knees. If you don't have a blanket, or if ever you're in a yoga class where you don't have any cushioning, but you need some support for your knees, your mat can always double up as your cushioning. So you can always fold up your mat in the middle to give your knees some cushioning. Same thing with the top of the mat to give your wrists some cushioning. You can also use your pillow under your wrist if you need that. So we're coming into hands and knees, tabletop posture, shoulders lined up with the wrists, the knees about hip width apart. Now, yogi's choice here to either curl your toes under or to rest the tops of the feet on the mat, whatever feels good. You want to notice that you're not dumping or collapsing into your shoulders. So if you feel that, press into the mat. What I like to say, press into the earth. It's like you're trying to push the earth away to come out of those shoulders, keeping the arms active. And we're going to begin to move through what's called our cow and cat breaths, or cow and cat tilts. We'll begin by inhaling, pressing the heart forward. Feel your belly drop as you arch the back. Maybe you're lifting the gaze here. This is your cow. And as you exhale, press into the mat. chin into chest, round the spine. This is your cat. So think of like a scaredy cat. Inhale, heart presses forward. Exhale, chin to chest, round the spine. This is your movement. Inhale, coming forward. Exhale, rounding the spine. Let's find five more at your own pace, just really feeling yourself connect your breath and your movement. Breathing in, exhaling out. Breathing in, exhaling out. Let's take one more breath in. Exhale. Good. And then we're going to bring the gaze back to the top of the mat and start to build just a little teeny tiny bit of heat for the core. So my regular yoga students know that I love to do these knee curls from hands and knees. In our most active classes, we do like 10, 15, but today we're just going to do 5. So let's inhale, lift that right leg, the knee bends. You can point the toes. And lift up through the thigh. Try to control that knee so it's not flying, you know, out to the right side of the mat or just not in control. Control the knee by controlling the thigh. Inhale, lift. Exhale, knee comes to the nose, round the back. Inhale, lift up through the thigh. Heart presses forward. Exhale, knee into the nose, round the spine. Lift, heart presses forward. Exhale, knee to the nose. Last two, lift. Exhale, knee to nose. Lift. Exhale, knee to nose. Last one, lift. Exhale, knee to nose. Good. Let's rest that knee down. We're going to do the opposite side. Lifting up that left knee, pressing up through the left thigh. Breath in. Exhale, knee to nose. Lift. Exhale, knee to nose. Last three here. Lift. Keep breathing. Keep smiling. Two more, lifting up, knee to nose. This is good for your glutes, your thighs, and your core. One more lift. Exhale, knee to nose. And then let's drop the knee, bring the big toes into touch. We're gonna open up the knees, the width of the mat, pressing back into what is usually a fan favorite, child's pose. You can extend your arms forward here, keeping the elbows lifted or resting the elbows on the ground. You can fold up your arms to support your head with your arms if you need that. You can place cushioning under your knees, under your bum, under the tops of your feet. Just take what you need here. Find a deep breath in. Exhale out. So in my regular classes, I always talk about how child's pose is such an ultimate posture of release and surrender. And so often in our lives, we may feel ourselves fighting against the current, you know, of things that we are trying to achieve, things that just seem like they're working against us as we're trying to move forward. Hold on to things we don't want to let go of. We hold on to things that are not serving us, whether it's, you know, a thought that doesn't serve us, a relationship. And so when we're in child's pose, I always invite students to just really bring to mind something that it's time to let go of. Something that's just no longer serving you. Take a beautiful breath in, and as you exhale, just really feel yourself releasing that thing or those things, even if it's just for this moment. And then feel yourself nurtured and supported by this posture. So much freedom in letting go. Just have to give yourself permission and trust yourself to do so, knowing that freedom and a life of authenticity is on the other side. Let's take one more deep breath in. Exhale out. Nice and easy. We're going to come up to hands and knees. And now, yogis, I'm going to guide us into downward facing dog. So for those who have a regular yoga practice with down dog, go ahead, find your way there. Otherwise, I'm just going to cue it through for my newer yogis. So for my newer yogis, you're gonna walk your hands forward so your wrists are in front of your shoulders, not in line with your shoulders. So a slight angle to the arms. Fingertips point forward, creases of the wrist point forward. Tuck your toes under, take a breath in, exhale. Lift your knees, lift your hips. Bringing the body into the shape of an upside down V. Now, for my yogis that are like, no, this is just too much, or this is just not in the practice today, you can stay on hands and knees, just take some movement, go through that cow and cat. For my yogis who may be working through wrist injuries, if down dog feels good in your body, but you need some wrist support, come down to your forearms, interlace your fingers, and then lift the knees, lift the hips. This is a modification of down dog. This is also called dolphin pose. So sometimes yogis may not have wrist injuries, but they want to take dolphin pose because it is a strengthener for the shoulders. It's a shoulder strengthening posture. So take whatever you need, wherever you are. For my yogis who want a little bit more, maybe take a leg lift, circle your knees. Take whatever you need. Maybe you're pedaling the feet, rocking the hips, shaking the head. I'm having a little sweaty hand syndrome here, so my hands are slipping on the mat. I'm gonna put my blanket here for that. So if you're experiencing that as well, blanket can feel good there to stop the sweat. Let's take two or three more breaths here. Now you don't have to press your heels all the way down to the mat in down dog. In fact, I prefer yogis to take a soft bend to the knees so that it takes pressure off the lower back. So just be where you are. It's not about perfection. It's just about feeling good in the posture. All right, loves, let's take one more deep breath in. Exhale out. And then from here, we're gonna walk our feet up to meet our hands. If you're in hands and knees, step one foot forward and then the next, so that we're all in a standing forward bend at the top of the mat, or standing forward fold. If your fingertips don't reach the ground, take a soft bend to the knees to support your fingers coming down. Or you can rest hands on ankles, shins, the backs of the calves, whatever feels good. The top of the head draws all the way down to the mat. If this doesn't feel good in your body, you know, with high or low blood pressure, you'll bring your gaze slightly forward. That's going to take pressure off the head. Let's hold here for two more breaths. Soft bend to the knees, squeeze your thighs, lift your hips. Nice stretch for the back of the legs that also helps to open up the lower back. One more deep breath in. Exhale out. Inhale your hands to shins or your knees. Your gaze is gonna come forward into what we call a flat back. So press your heart forward, press your shoulders back. We call this a halfway lift. Take one more deep breath in. Exhale, come back into that forward fold. And then we're slowly gonna rise to standing, taking a soft bend to the knees. And then inhale. As you uncurl the spine, take your time, take your time, take your time. Feel your spine stack one ring, one vertebra at a time. When you are fully in standing, inhale, bring the arms up. Pause here as you take a breath in and a breath out. Take a nice side stretch here. Let's take hold of your left wrist with your right hand. Inhale to gently pull that left arm up, and on the exhale, gently pull that left arm over to the right. So finding that stretch again on the left side of the body. For my yogis who want a little bit more, you can step that right foot behind the left, take a soft bend to the left knee, and then pull, pull, pull to the right a little bit more. So just see what feels good. Again, try not to hug your ears with your arms. Always wanting to feel space. Keep breathing, keep smiling. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Let's take one more breath in this way. Exhale out. You have that right foot behind, step that right foot back up to meet the left. Release the left wrist, taking hold of the right. Now we're gonna take that on the opposite side. Deep breath in. Exhale, pull it over to the left. When stretches feel really good and yummy in the body, sometimes you just get a good stretch that I say can feel like really juicy and good. I always say, isn't it great that we have two sides of the body so you can feel that all over again? If you want a little bit more, you can step that left foot behind the right. Pulling, pulling, pulling over to the left. Not yanking, gentle pull. Oh man, this feels awesome in my right side of my body. One more breath in. Exhale out. If you have that left foot behind, step the left foot up to meet the right. Let's release the right wrist. Bring hands behind the back. Interlace your fingers. So now we're going to get into the shoulders, and I'm going to offer two options to meet you where you are. Option one, take a breath in. Exhale, press the hands away from the lower back so you can take this standing and just lift the arms. Now, if interlacing fingers feels like too much for your shoulders or where you are in your body, you can grab opposite wrists or elbows and just lift away. Just take what you need. Then you can either stay here if this feels good, or to make this a little bit deeper, soften to the knees, inhale, lift the arms a little bit more, and as you exhale, bring the arms over the head into a forward fold. If you are gritting your teeth or squinting your eyes, relax and soften your response. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Just a little more movement, yogis, and then we will find our way into that restorative posture. Let's take two more breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath in. Exhale out. If you are in that forward fold, soften to the knees as we come back up to standing. And then we can bring the arms back to the lower back, release the hands, the wrists, elbows, whatever you have. Give your arms a little shake there. Shoulders a little shake, feet, legs a little shake. Get the wiggles out, whatever you need to get out. I think we might have had some little ones on here today, so get your little wiggles out, little ones, if you need to. And then let's just do a little bit more. We're gonna work through a lunge, a high lunge, and then we're gonna take tree pose. I could not teach this yoga class without doing tree pose. So to get us all into high lunge safely, let's start with our hands and our hips. Again, for my yogis that have this in their practice, go ahead, move as you know to move. Otherwise, let's take a breath in, exhale, generous step back with your right foot. We're gonna bend that left knee. Now, you wanna make sure your left knee is in line with your ankle at what we call that 90 degree angle, and try not to have that knee rolling out to the left side or dropping all the way into the right. So you wanna have that knee nice and strong, pointing forward in line with the right ankle. Now, if you need the support, you can keep the hands on the hips. You're still getting a beautiful hip opener here, which is what this lunge offers, as well as strengthening for the thighs. Otherwise, if you're ready, inhale, sweep the arms up. Now, what's gonna really support you here are your core muscles. So on your next exhale, draw that navel into the spine, not so that you're sucking your breath in and just holding it in, but so that you feel the engagement of those muscles there, and then find your breath. For my yogis who want a little bit more, you can let that right knee hover above the mat. You can do a little pulsing here. Wherever you are, let's hold for five. Soft shoulders, reach up through those fingertips. Four. Three. Two. This is the little bit of active that we're doing in the class today. One, take a breath in. Exhale out, hands to the hips, nice and easy. Step your right foot up to meet your left. Beautiful. Let's go ahead to the opposite side. You can start with hands on the waist, or if you're feeling jazzy and you want to bring your arms up, stepping right back into the lunge, honor the body. Take a breath in, exhale, generous step back with your left foot, right knee bends, arm sweep up. If this feels good to you, left knee hovers. If you want a little bit more, keep that right knee in line with the ankle. Breathe and relax the face. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Three more breaths, reaching up through your fingertips. One more deep breath in. Exhale out. Hands come to the waist, nice and easy. Step your left foot up to meet your right. Take a breath in here and exhale out. All right, yogis, for tree pose, I'm gonna turn and face the camera just so everybody can see what I'm doing here. And I'm gonna offer this one in stages. So let's go ahead again, starting with hands on the waist. I just wanna meet everybody where they are. Again, if you have tree pose in your practice, go ahead and find your way in the tree pose. Otherwise, hands on the waist. Let's start by lifting the right heel, shifting our weight into our left leg. Now for stage one, tuck that right heel against the left ankle. For stage two, the right foot against the left shin, below your knee. Stage three, the right foot on the inside of the left thigh, above the knee. You never want to place your foot on the knee, and conveniently the foot, the arch of the foot, fits so nicely on the knee, right? But we never want to put pressure on the knee because it can cause the knee to blow out, it can cause injury, so we always want to stay away from putting pressure on the knee. Now, if you're like, you know what, I'm gonna get my foot on that thigh, and you're putting your foot in your thigh, but you're doing this, be where you are. Be where you are so you can be in the posture. Maybe today you're here, maybe later or tomorrow you're here. There are days when I'm on the thigh, there are days when I'm by the ankle. Draw that left hip in a little bit, open up that right knee, and then if you need the support, hands stay on the waist, or inhale, reach your arms up, grow your tree. Soft shoulders. If you are gripping that mat for dear life with your left toes, relax the left toes, squeeze the left thigh, engage your core muscles, breathe, steady your gaze on something that isn't moving. That's what helps you find your balance in these postures. Two more breaths, loves. One more deep breath in. Exhale out, left leg is probably like, please. Let's inhale, sweep the arms up. If you are, have the hands by the heart or anything like that, we're just finding our way back to our hips. Release that right foot, lift that right knee just a little bit, and then exhale, rest the foot down to the mat. Give that left leg a shake. So what you're feeling in the left leg is why I'm gonna say, squeeze the right thigh. When you keep the standing leg active and engaged, it's gonna take away some of the discomfort. So let's go ahead and move to the opposite side. I know folks are like, can we please get to this restorative posture? We are almost there, loves. Let's go ahead and do the other side. Lift that left heel, shift your weight into your right leg. Start squeezing your right thigh, your right glute. Tuck that left heel against ankle, shin, or thigh. Now, here's what's really funny about our bodies. You might be totally balanced on one side, super wobbly on the other. You might have the thigh on one side, the ankle on the other. Just be where you are, no judgment. Just be where you are, keep hands on your waist, grow your tree, hands to heart, take whatever you need. Sometimes I like to say, if you grow your tree, sway your arms back and forth as though the wind were blowing. Play around with your balance there. Keep squeezing that right leg, relax those right toes. Let's take three more breaths. Engage those core muscles. Soften your shoulders. Smile, smile, smile. One more breath in. Exhale out. Hands to the waist. Lift that left knee as you release the left foot off of the right leg. Exhale, rest the foot down. And shake out the legs as you need to. We're gonna work our way back down to the mat. While you're standing, if you have your chair nearby, go ahead and grab your chair. Just to bring it a little bit closer. Don't bring it on the mat just yet, but just to get it in the area because we are gonna be moving that way soon. And then otherwise, we're gonna turn to the top of the mat. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, come into that forward fold. Now here, yogis, you can step back into down dog, stepping back into that upside down V, or come right on down to hands and knees. So be where you are. Wherever that is, take another breath in. Exhale out. Now let's all come down to the knees. We'll take one more child's pose here, big toes into touch.
knees extending the width of the mat, press the bum back. Extend the arms forward. We have one more posture after this bridge pose, which is a beautiful way to open up the heart, give the spine a little stretch, and then we will come to rest. Take one more breath in here. Exhale out. Beautiful. Coming up ever so slightly onto your back. If you want to grab your cushion to support your head and your neck here, go ahead and grab that. Otherwise, let's go ahead, come onto the back with your knees bent, the arms alongside the body, the palms face down. And then have your feet just hip width apart here. So if your feet are as wide as the mat, walk the feet into a little bit of a closer distance, and then walk your heels into your bum so you can tickle or graze your heels with your fingertips. Take a breath in. Exhale out. Nice and easy on the inhale, pressing down through the soles of the feet. Gently lift the hips away from the mat and towards the ceiling. This is your bridge pose. A cue that I love to give here is picturing an imaginary beach ball, squeezing between the thighs, or you're squeezing that beach ball between your thighs. This helps to keep your thighs active, keeps the knees under control. This posture, a beautiful way to increase flexibility in the spine, strengthens the thighs, opens up the heart from an emotional perspective. Ah, lift a little higher if you have it in you. Take another breath in. Exhale out. And then on your next exhale, nice and easy, very nice and easy, lower down from the top of the spine to the base of the spine. You never want to just collapse or drop out of bridge. Take your time. Once your spine completely reconnects with the mat, just give yourself a breath in and a breath out. And then let's gently hug the knees into the chest, wrapping arms around shins, knees, backs of thighs, maybe gently rocking from side to side or front to back. Maybe turning the head from side to side or tilting the head up and down. When you add this rocking motion, it provides a gentle massage for the lower back. If you didn't want to rock, but instead just wanted to press the thighs into the belly, this is a gentle massage for the abdominal muscles. So in yoga speak, this posture is called apanasana. Its literal translation means wind relieving pose. So if ever you have some wind that needs some relief, this posture can help you find that. Let's take one more breath in. Exhale out. Nice and easy, rest the soles of the feet back to the ground, and then drop your knees to the left or to the right to very gently press yourself up, and let's set up for our restorative posture. I'm going to pause the music just for a second so we can all get settled in. Now, if you have that cushion at the top of the mat for your head and your neck, go ahead and keep that there. Let's grab your chair and bring it onto the mat. If you don't have a chair, you can stack pillows, blankets, just anything that you can stack up that will allow you to elevate your legs. If you don't have that, maybe you just have a pillow or one blanket, you can tuck that under the knees, you can tuck that under your ankles or the soles of your feet, or your heels rather, to give your feet a little elevation as you're lying flat. If you have yoga blocks or books, you can again do that under the knees, under the heels as you're lying flat, just to give yourself a little elevation. So there's something everybody can take to make this truly, truly restorative. Otherwise, let's go ahead and bring your bum back to the mat and swing your legs up on the chair, nice and simple. And just adjust yourself so it feels just right. Walk your hands back as you come to lie back. Grab your eye pillow or your eye mask, whatever you have to cover the eyes here. Oh, so amazing. And then come to lay back on your pillow, your cushion. I like to say line up your cushion directly with your shoulder so it can fall flush under the head and the neck. and just keep adjusting until it feels just right. The goal of a restorative posture is to be able to be in the posture. So you don't want to be sitting there like, oh, my leg doesn't feel right. Oh, this doesn't feel right. Take the time that you need so that the posture feels good for you, so that you can really just enjoy the posture. Arms can rest alongside the body with the palms down for grounding. You can open up the arms out to the side like a T with the palms facing up. You can take goalpost arms or cactus arms. You can rest the hands in the belly, the womb, the heart, whatever feels good for you. And again, for my yogis who don't have a chair, you can bring the legs completely straight out onto the mat, supporting your knees, placing cushioning under your heels to elevate the feet. You can tuck something under your lower back. So just take something, find something that feels good. And if none of that feels good, if you prefer to just lay flat on out in like a starfish posture, go ahead and take that. Wherever you are, find a deep breath in. And as you exhale, if it feels good, close the eyes. Relax your jawline, unclench your teeth. Feel your shoulders soften, feel your spine release into the mat. And here, just give yourself permission just to be. Restorative postures help to deeply nourish the body from the inside out. They help to soften and settle the mind. So feel your breath here. If your mind wanders or becomes distracted, have no worries. Just notice the distraction. Take a breath in and come back to the present. If you do have the feet elevated, this is a wonderful way to take pressure off the ankles. This is really great for relaxing the mind, for stabilizing the pelvis. As you continue to rest, I'm going to share a passage from Melody Beattie's Journey to the Heart, Daily Meditations on the Path to Freeing Your Soul. And this passage is called Discover the Power of Loving Yourself. Sometimes it's hard to trust life with all its sudden twists, turns, and storms. When something unexpected or painful happens, when we become blocked or frustrated, when life takes a different course than we hoped it would, it's easy to stop trusting the flow of our lives. I didn't ask for this. It's not fair. I don't want this, we think. This road isn't leading anywhere, at least nowhere I want to go. Often when we feel life has turned on us, we respond by turning on ourselves. But turning on ourselves doesn't help. In fact, it can compound the situation. It can prevent us from hearing and acting on the very guidance that will lead us through, get us through, and take us to the next place. It can prevent us from hearing our heart. Keep loving yourself and taking care of yourself, no matter what, through the storms, the twists, the turns, and the blocks. Take a moment, breathe deep. Restore yourself to that sacred place of self-love and self-responsibility.
feel all your feelings, then let them go. Love yourself until you can hear your heart and what it tells you to do. Love yourself until you find the courage to act on that guidance. Loving yourself is a powerful tool, a powerful force for change. It can reconnect you to creativity, to universal love, to the best possible flow of events within your life. It can and will reconnect you to life's magic. There is a trustworthy road through whatever life brings. Loving yourself will help you find it. Begin to find our way to awareness. First by taking a deep breath in. Exhaling out. Finding gentle movement first by pressing your thumbs against each fingertip. Maybe making a circling motion with your thumbs, giving a little massage to the fingertips there. Beginning to gently wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, maybe circle around your ankles and your wrists. If you have your legs on the chair and it's available to you, go ahead and hug the knees into the chest. Otherwise, just rest your feet somehow, some way in the chair where you can rock the knees from side to side. Need to push the chair away a little bit. If that is available to you as well, you can do that. Maybe turn the head from side to side or tilt the head up and down. And then nice and easy, rocking all the way to your right side, resting in a fetal position with the head supported by the hands.
resting here as you take another breath in and exhale. And using your top hand to very gently press into the earth, press into the ground, and press yourself back up into that comfortable seated posture you were in at the beginning of our time together, sitting with legs crossed on knees, with legs straight in front, whatever feels good to you and for you. And if it speaks to you, I invite you to rest your hands on heart, left hand on heart, right hand on top of left. We're going to bring your knees together in prayer position at the heart. And if that doesn't speak to you, just rest the hands on the belly, the thighs. Close the eyes if this feels good here. Soften your shoulders, lengthen your spine. And at the end of every class, I always like to offer taking a moment to reflect on your practice. Just noticing what came up for you, what resonated with you, what felt a benefit to you, for you. Reflecting on the words of the passage to discover the power of loving yourself. I've been in those places where loving myself is the last thing I want to do, the last thing I feel capable of doing. I've been in those places where it's an emotional rock bottom. When you just take one foot, put it in front of the other, find a little love to give yourself, a little grace, a little gratitude, a little compassion. That'll give you the strength you need to keep putting one foot in front, one foot in front of the other, keep moving forward. Compassion, joy, peace, happiness, love, it all starts at home. And the more you're able to extend these things to yourself, the more you're able to give these things out into the world. So I hope today, I hope this practice is a practice that supports you in your journey of loving yourself. I hope that this is a place you can come back to if you feel like you need a little love, because I'm always here for you. And just take this moment now to tell yourself thank you. Tell yourself I love you. Tell yourself I trust you. And tell yourself I forgive you. Together, let's take one more full deep breath in. Exhale, exhale, exhale the air out. May you all be happy. May you all be free. May you all be peaceful, 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 and joyful. The light in me honors the light in each and every one of you. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining today. Light in me honors the light in you. And namaste. Thank you so much, yogis. And I know people are jumping off. I'm seeing all the chats coming up.